Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video we will learn two different formulas of Microsoft Excel. First one is days, other one is days 360. So let's start with days first. Days formula is used to calculate the number of days within two dates. As in our case, we have employees master sheet where we have our employees, their ID, their joining and resigning date. Now with the help of this formula, we can calculate the number of days a particular employee has worked for us. So you'll use our formula here, which is equals to DAYS tab. Now as it is asking for end date, so we'll select this resigning date, then comma and start date. So we'll select joining date, bracket over and enter. Now you can see days here. So we'll copy it by pressing Ctrl C. Then we'll paste these here by pressing Ctrl V and then Ctrl and then formulas. Now you can see number of days worked by each employee. And our next formula is days 360. So now we will learn how to use days 360 formula in Microsoft Excel, which works same like days formula, but the main difference between these two is the number of days in a year. So as its name indicates, this formula counts 360 days in a year. So it will ignore 5 days, like it will assume every month has 30 days only. Let's use it here. So we'll use it by pressing equals to days 360 tab. I will select our start date. So we have here, then comma, then end date, and comma. Now you can choose between two methods. One is US and other is European. So I will go with US, then tab, bracket over and enter. Now we can copy it by pressing Ctrl C and paste it here by pressing Ctrl V, then Ctrl F, and here you go. Now if we compare days worked in both the formulas, you will see a slight difference between these two. And obviously the number of days will be less in days 360 because it is excluding 5 days of the year. If this video was helpful, please hit that like button, comment down if you have any questions, share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe.